Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hello men, dear boys. This time, I share a joyful article on the returnofkings.com. Not talking about death and all, but more about life, and the 9 points to make the most of it. I am not 100% in agreement with all of it as of now, but having a different point of view on life, showing another perspective is also an opportunity to learn something sometimes. Hoping that will be the same to you folks. Here we go, the 9 secrets to living a joyful life. Life doesn't always have to be boring or sad just because most of the world is. Below I will share some of the ways I try to make my reality more pleasing and satisfying. Point number 1, avoid toxic people and negative thoughts. I know it easier said than done. But in case you want to live a joyful life, it's quite important for you to practice not thinking negatively. Negative mentality can have extremely bad consequences for your health, mental sanity and habits, thus it should be avoided at all cost. However, I know the truth is that it's quite impossible for us to be happy all the time, since there are several things that can lead us to start thinking negatively even if we try our best not to. Some of them include relationship problems, toxic people, life misfortunes, and so on. But still, in case you want to avoid bitterness infecting yourself, it best to try your best not to let these events consume you. The best tip I can give you is to avoid as much as possible events or toxic people that trigger these negative thought patterns. Point number 2, travel. Traveling can be a good way to replenish your energy, make you reflect on life, and give you enough mojo to make sure that when you get back to your routine and homeland, you will be at your ease, which will translate in you working harder through the rest of the year. If you can travel with your best friends or family members, I recommend you to do so. It can be one of the best bonding time experience. However, never underestimate the power of traveling on your own. A lot of people are afraid of traveling alone, thinking it might not be fun or enjoyable at all, but the truth is, if you know yourself well enough, traveling alone can in fact be more enjoyable than traveling with friends or family. Point number 3, spend more time with family or those who are fond of you. Let's face it, your family might not be perfect, neither is mine, but they are probably reliable people that you can always count on. Spend more time with them or with some of your best friends that you know who will always have your back. In our matrix, we are forced to waste so much time with people we don't really like or don't care about at all. The best way to rebel against the system is to make sure you spend more time with people you really care about. Point number 4, don't spend all your time playing video games. Well, this one is quite obvious. If you are not where you want to be, you should be hustling right now instead of wasting your valuable time with video games or other time-sinking activities. Cheap forms of entertainment such as games or movies are a great way to refill your energy if you can go out or travel, but they do turn into a problem if they are becoming an addiction, thus leading to procrastination. I've seen a boy so addicted with his MMORPGs that he even declined a date with a hot girl just to keep leveling up his stupid fictional character for an entire night. Believe me. Point number 5, read books and biographies from great men of the past. No great book can replace a great mentor. However, no one has the luxury to have a mentor who has deep knowledge about every subject in life. This is where biographies and technical books come in handy. If you can find someone in real life to advise you about a certain area you don't have any experience on, search for books that might have answers about what you are looking for. I believe that reading biographies or autobiographies from great men of the past is one of the best ways to find the secret of living a joyful life. At least for me, there isn't anything more inspirational than to be able to see how great men of centuries ago were once mere average Joes with flaws and facing life problems just like any of us. Every man who succeeded and reached prosperity had to first go through a lot of struggle, pain, and deception before reaching the top. Whatever your final goal is right now, it's quite important that you never become arrogant to the point of believing you don't need to improve yourself nor look for mentors. Point number 6. Fail big. Failure is a good way to improve ourselves and discover who we really are. It's an adventure of self-discovery. Unfortunately, We live in a culture where people are so worried about their image that they rather never risk themselves in new pursuits due to being afraid of looking like a fool. Thus, they end up never improving themselves. Remember this, you can never become the best version of yourself if you don't want to risk failing, whether it is trying to game a girl, opening a business, playing an instrument, and so on. Point number 7. Be an example to those around you. Not everyone is bitter because they opted to be. A lot of people became toxic due to life events making them become disillusioned with the world and humanity. However, if they are willing to listen to you and change, you should try to help them out. But if you notice that they are refusing your aid, and their negativity cancer is starting to affect your look in life, then move on and ghost them if necessary. Point number 8. You want to always get what you want. If you can accept that you want to always get what you want, without throwing a tantrum like a spoiled brat, you are more likely to become a real man and a more down-to-earth kind of person. Last point, point number 9, find a sanctuary to keep you sane during the hard times. There will be times that we will be going through a lot in life. Nothing that we try will be working out while we encounter failure after failure. When those periods arrive, it's always good to have some kind of shelter to keep you sane. If you have something or someone to fall your back on, it can be way easier to endure those difficult periods. My shelter during hard times is reading the Bible, but if you are not a religious person, look for something else to keep you sane. Your sanctuary can be one of your hobbies, someone you trust, or whatever that can keep your mind too busy to think about negative things. To conclude, to sum it up, we have the power to create our own realities, even if we are not rich. How will you sculpt your world from now on?
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.